Hello, good evening everyone. Today we are going to talk about free predictions for the for 1 year, and the first person going to come in this sequence is Amitabh Desai, and he is going to have the dasha from the predictions are limited from first week of 19 to first week of 2020. First week of 19 to December first week of 2020. This is applicable. So in which he has, we have seen that he has put lot of stress for this year on the third house. Third house is a house of communication, and we also had found that there is a lot of communication which is going on during this particular year. And also the third house is also indicates for short travels and short trips, and there is some kind of intelligence which are connected to the third house also. So the communication means, what is the communication here? So communication here, it means that lot of communication is going on between brothers, sisters, neighbors. So the communication, when we say, can be both written as well as verbal form of communication, with lot of thoughts involved in that. And this particular house is also house of loss and also the sustenance house of marriage for this gentleman. So, and in this we can see the fourth house lord, Mars, and ninth house lord Mars is there. And we already had stressed that Mars is a badak for Leo Lagna, and it is linked with Mercury, who is the second lord and 11th lord. So he has put some kind of an efforts in communication for the sustenance of marriage, we can say, or the area where the loss is happening, and he has made some kind of a communication related to that area, and for which he has made some short travels, everything he has kept involvement with the environment he lives in. And how sharpened he has made his intelligence to work during this period, and all it is also about the courage, valor, and the kind of weapons, the kind of things what one carries in hand. So everything is basically third house, and we can see the art of communication there, and plus the communication which is related to Mercury, Mars. These are the people who are coming in picture. And Mars is also the person who is supposed to give the career also for this person. So some kind of I have taken this prediction in two ways. The first one is he is doing some kind of a short communication. He is doing something related to communicate with the people around him, brothers, sisters, neighbors, etc. And also has stressed the fact that he has put some kind of an efforts in communicating or taking an action or a drive related to the sustenance of marriage. And we also had found that there is some loss happening in that area. This is division number one. If I take the chapter two as an option, it can be either or. So in that chapter two, I can see that it can give you something which is related to the career, initiative taken, or a new enterprise been opened, or a new contract has been signed off. So when we say the career, everything is focused towards this area about contracts, agreement, the career initiatives, etc. And everything which is connected to the second house and 11th house of income. So money is involved. So whether it is going to be the earlier case or the career, the second option, in both the cases there is money involved, and there is a loss involved also. There is no any second thought about loss. That is also there. In case of the career, third house is a house of enterprise. Third house is a house of new initiatives, and these are the things possible. Okay, but in either the format, the person will be brought to the area of, if it is a former one, definitely there will be something which is connected to the marriage. If it is a later one, there will be something connected to the business. So there are only two options, and either way, there are a lot of communication, there is a lot of short trips, there is a lot of contract signing agreement, and new initiative, new drives, new communication pattern, lot of Guru Upadesha is also happening. The Gurus are coming and giving some advices, because third house is the house of Guru Upadesha, and third house is also the house of copulation. Third house is a house of short journeys. Third house is a house of communication. Third house is a house of siblings. Third house is a house of habits and the kind of arms we keep, the kind of things which we keep in our hands. So all these areas are the key focus area for this year, and I look forward to his comments to give some tips again. Thank you, and we are going to the second chart. The second chart is Vidya Ravankar. So I am just picking her chart. One second. Vidya Ravankar. And in Vidya's case, the Dasha has started from 26 November. And to be precise, it is 20 November, and it is going to end up by 15th November next year. That is, this year, 2020. So in this year, she has gone through 12th house matters. So what is 12th house? 12th house matters. So 12th house immediately talks about partnership. 12th house talks about losses and expenditures. One moment. Okay, so we can see that in the 12th house there are an array of planet in 12th house. And in the 12th house we can say Venus, Mercury and Jupiter is present. Jupiter is the first lord and the fourth lord. And Mercury is the 7th and the 10th house, and Venus is 6th lord and 11th lord. So all of them are giving an indication that she has involved, and the 12th house is a house of unconscious. And it also is a house where it assists us to come out from our failures. Success and failure is always confront to in our life. So this is a house where we decide that what is our exit area, and we calculate what is the strength and weaknesses which are hidden from the public. So, and also this is a house where we feel some kind of a bondage. We are stuck, we are confined, we are put up in a jail. Not necessarily jail means it's a physical jail. Jail can be even in life also, we can be feel like living like in a jail. We are living in an asylum. We are living in a hospital. So some kind of a freedom is what is actually the mind is looking for. But the 12th house is coming in the form of a danger. It also gives secret enemies and also about the clandestine affairs. However, this is a house of positive transformations also. So, when you visit the unconscious and meeting with the past, then you can able to come out with what is the future which is going to offer. So, as I said, this particular year, when she started with this November 20, 2019, she is undergoing a lot of transformation, and the transformation all is happening in the 12th house of partnership. And that is also involved with her intelligence, and it is also involved with her mental happiness. And Mercury is also talking about 7th house and 10th house, which means the spouse and the career. And one side the Venus is telling that I am also giving her fights, confrontations and litigations. And 6th level, Venus is also talking about income. So you can see the kind of focus there, intense focus. So the Venus is telling that there will be lot of journeys this year. You will be doing lot of journeys, and these journeys mostly will be associated with some kind of transformation, or this house is a very threatening house basically. It gives lot of destruction for better. So but the destruction also will be painful when the destruction happens. And this year is also a strugglesome year for resources, because it is placed in the second from the Aruda. So it gives some kind of a resources type of problem. But at the same time, there is an intense struggle and a death kind of scenario happen for better. And that is why I am stressing here, death-like suffering. And after the suffering happens, the person will be transforming for the new. So here the kind of focus is all given to the Venus, which is 6th house and 11th house of job, career and income. Because Venus is, first of all, is in the 12th house. 12th house I already explained about expenditures, losses, which has come to the life, transformations. She has to undergo transformation. She has to undergo that transformation in her mental happiness, in her intelligence, in her spouse, in a marriage life, in career. So many transformations are happening around her. And Venus is 6th house also, so there is intense focus for getting a job, getting good income, and also plus improving her image in the society. So see the challenges which are giving in this year. So I am telling that this year also would have given her a lot of travels, like the earlier gentleman. This Vidya Ravankar also would have given a lot of traveling, plus intense focus towards partnership, expenditure, losses which are put into, and also for 6,000 of job, income, confrontations, litigations, fights, debts. You see, everything is coming in the 6th and 11th. And the 11th house is also about the social interactions, what we do. So she also develops that. She has to do that, since she will be consulting astrology. 11th house is astrology. So see her concentration here. So she will be doing all that to find out what is life offering her, in short. But overall, this year is a lot of transformation year for her, and all the best to you. And then next we are going to a person called as Sai Ram. So Sai Ram is also a very interesting case. His Dasha has started again from first week of November 2019 and ends up in the second week of 2019. And in his case, who is the main planet? And the main planet is the 8th house, where you can find out Rahu and Saturn sitting. And 8th house. So you can understand the previous person's was 8th house, sorry, 12th house, and in this gentleman's case it is 8th house. So 8th house is a very serious dustana. Among all, it is one of the painful dustana. And 8th house is house of commonly referred to the house of interactions, how it is happening in whatever relationships can bring us, how that relationship we can bring out most of out of it. And the emphasis will be on post-marital relationship, like sex. And it is also about death and transformation, new beginning, rebirth, or the soul which is gaining for a partnership. So 8th house is all about an equal opportunity house, placing death, rebirth, sex on the same level playing field, acknowledging the importance of all the three. So we all experience the kind of death and rebirth every day as part of our lives, correct? And we also expect the failed relationships, and leading to a new one, career changes, new hairstyle, a new phase of life. So you can call everything which is related to the 8th house, everything will be focused towards transformation. So and every day we need to transform, otherwise it's very difficult. And 8th house is the house of inheritance, it is also the house of alimony, it is also the house of taxes, it is also houses of debts, insurance and support from another. Financial support, spiritual, emotional and physical support, all been addressed in this house. And and this 8th house is giving two kind of impact. One is for the income generating people, and for the 7th house it becomes a very important house, which is second house to the 7th. So if a person is married, then this will be the house of sustenance, or where one person has to transform. That is why how we are managing your interactions, relationships, how you are managing your rituals, how are you managing your death, rebirth, and kind of post-marital relationships, all given very high level of importance over here. And the combination Rahu and Saturn, both dire malefics are sitting in the 8th house, and the 8th house significator itself is Saturn. So it's a very intense Saturn 8th house happening for him. So I feel that there will be a lot of transformation. And that transformation is looked like a gain for others, for the society. And in the Mahabharata, it is said that everything is, whatever is going on is good, for the good. So I also feel the same for this gentleman, and I am eager to hear from him what kind of things are happening in his life. And it is also the house of, the Saturn is also co-ruling the 9th house of Dharma. And he is also the co-ruling the from the Aruda Lagna, it is 12th house lord also. So there is some kind of a loss, perceived loss is expected in the income, perceived loss is expected in the social life or a friend. So 11th house is all about friendship as well. And it is also been seen that how the fruits of post-marital happiness is going to transform or to affect. Everything is from this house only. So in that way, if I am seeing that 8th house anyway is all giving the utmost importance to whatever the matters which I have said, and I am now eager to find out from him what is going on. So I hope you enjoyed our day-to-day predictions for the members who are our YouTube subscribers. And we suggest that you have to recommend our channel, and you, if you are not subscribed yet, kindly subscribe, and also refer our channel to your friends, relatives and dear and near for them to get benefited by our channel. Thank you very much once again. Bye-bye.